come back to the welding school. In the old school, you know. Welding a root weld today on 3G PF cut weld. It's a 230 degree angle. We did a 2 millimeter landing this way. And we've got around the 2.5 to 3 millimeter gap. I use a 2.5 gap wire. And like a loose cut. Here is a bigger on the top. So that when the heat travels and it's closing, we still got our, we still maintain our 2.5 gap. So welding on 18 volts. And technique is just the side to side on the root faces. Just to get a positive boot so that we can cross it through. 10 millimeter plate. So I'm going to do a root and I'm going to try and cut it. Okay, there goes the root. To stop it just before the end so it would, you could see the keyhole that we tried to maintain. No matter how much you're weaving, what size gap you've got, as long as you're maintaining that keyhole. As soon as you're weaving and keyhole becomes smaller, you need to start concentrating in the center of the joint. That's the root laid in there, it's quite hot. Let me come to the penetration parts of it. And you see the key hole there, and you see that root's been maintaining it right from the bottom all the way up. What we like to see. Welcome back to the welding school. We have a Filipino doing what I love to do. We've got the root laid in. Now we go for the fill pot. So the technique will basically be the same, side to side, stay on the walls a little bit longer, and 16.5 volts, 3.2 meters per minute, wire feed. Let's give it a go. So nothing so difficult about the semi-automatic process. This is our full pass, and just enough, just under flush, keeping the lines of the devil, not crossing them over, and stay tuned. Stay on the sides a little bit and move up in a zigzag formation. Same 16.5 volts and 3.2 meters per minute. Let's check.